So with regard to Lebanon, the United States did not know about, nor was it involved in, these incidents, and we're still gathering the information and gathering the facts. Broadly speaking, we've been very clear, and we remain very clear, about the importance of all parties avoiding any steps that could further escalate the conflict that we're trying to resolve in Gaza, to see it spread to other fronts. It's clearly not in the interest of anyone involved to see that happen. And that's why, again, it's imperative that all parties refrain from any actions that could escalate the conflict. Egypt continues to be an indispensable partner in pursuing a ceasefire in Gaza, one that brings the hostages home, that relieves the suffering of the people of Gaza, and creates the foundation for an enduring peace. I thank the President and the Foreign Minister and other colleagues for Egypt's commitment to this work. And we discussed the importance of getting this deal across the finish line, something we'll continue to pursue along with our Qatari counterparts. We all know that a ceasefire is the best chance to tackle the humanitarian crisis in Gaza, to address the risks to regional stability, risks that I know are felt viscerally here in Egypt. In particular, the Houthis' continued attacks on global commerce in the Red Sea, aided and abetted by Iran, are reducing traffic in the Suez Canal, and that's cost Egypt a projected $5 billion in lost revenue.
Leon, how much do you expect this attack by Hezbollah, this attack on the Hezbollah?
We've made a tremendous amount of progress over the last month and a half. There are, I think, in the agreement, 18 paragraphs. 15 of them are agreed, but the remaining issues need to be resolved. The most important thing in this moment is seeing a demonstration of political will to finally conclude this agreement. And that's what we discussed. We also discussed in some detail what would be necessary arrangements if an agreement is finally reached in terms of the so-called day after. What happens in Gaza in terms of its governance, its security, its reconstruction. And here as well, Egypt is and will be a critical partner, and I think we had a very useful conversation about that today as well.